For the past decade, they've been the CFL's most consistent franchise. But for all of their success, championships have been difficult to find. Only one Grey Cup victory in six attempts.
Calvillo in the end zone, incomplete!
Their core of stars are quickly approaching retirement. Time is running out. As a new season dawns, their mantra is simple. Win the day. This is the story of the 2009 Montreal Alouettes and their journey to the Grey Cup.
Fun, no question about it. I think we squandered a great opportunity.
This game is over. John Huffnagel and the Stamps are champs.
Last year really left a sour taste in our mouth.
Right now, it just hurts.
Probably one of the most gut-wrenching defeats I've ever been a part of.
Take a little time to think about it and see if I have the energy and the hunger to come back.
They expected a storybook ending, but instead, the 96th Grey Cup in Montreal ended in heartache for the hometown Alouettes. It was their fourth Grey Cup loss in the past six seasons.
How many more chances are we going to get? These games are so difficult to get to, and of course, even more difficult to win.
Chances and time were running out for Montreal's core. Quarterback Anthony Calvillo was 36, center Brian Chu, 34, receiver Ben Cahoon, 36, and retirement was on the horizon.
What better way than to, you know, to win a championship in front of your hometown, in front of 60,000 people, and, you know, go out on top.
The big win has escaped Montreal for years. Besides capturing the Grey Cup in 02, the Alouettes suffered championship losses in 2000, 2003, 2005, 2006, and of course, 2008.
You never get over those losses. We've lost crazy ways. I mean, we've lost in double overtime.
He got it! Touchdown!
We've lost a couple times in the last play of the game, going for two-point conversions.
Here comes the blitz, Calvillo in the end zone, incomplete!
We never would have thought it would have been this hard, especially because we had so many opportunities.
It's just been one of those things where we can't get over that final hurdle, you know? We've been to six Grey Cups and we've won one.
It's just the way the game goes.
The 2009 offseason required major decisions from Montreal's veterans. The biggest would come from Calvillo, whose wife Alexia had just recovered from chemotherapy after being diagnosed with cancer in 2007.
There was a big test that we had to worry about in February that was gonna give us some either, you know, great news or bad news, and of course the great news came. So physically for me, I felt that I wanted to come back and play.
Calvillo re-signed with Montreal in February, joining teammates Chu and Cahoon, who signed a few months prior, setting the stage for another Grey Cup run.
They all felt we should have won it all a year ago. And when that happens, it leaves a very bitterness in your mouth. And you want to accomplish that feat the next year when something escapes you like that.
Welcome to McMahon Stadium. Happy Canada Day as we present the Grey Cup rematch between the Montreal Alouettes and the Calgary Stampeders.
For the Alouettes, the 2009 season starts at soggy McMahon Stadium, and revenge filled the air.
I think a lot of us realized what was at stake. And, you know, for to have the CFL season opener in Calgary on Canada Day, I mean, the stage was set.
Touchdown grab!
I'd be lying to say that it wasn't. It was more of like a redemption for us, I think.
Led by their veterans and the tutelage of coach Mark Trestman, Montreal explodes out of the gate.
Today, we are the beast of the CFL.
Do you believe it?
This is unreal.
By week 12, they clinch first place in the East and finish the season with a franchise best 15 wins.
We understand our roles as good as we ever have.
Well, that's another remarkable catch by Ben Cahoon.
So I guess I would say that this might be the best team I've been a part of.
This is our year. This is our team. And this is the best team I've been on and been associated with.
Are you kidding? This is unbelievable.
It is by far the best team I've ever been a part of, from the top on down.
Montreal was able to halt their competition all year, but they can't halt time. And as another East final approaches, the veterans realize this might be their last chance.
Now's the time for us to finish writing, you know, our strip, our journey, maybe the last chapter of our book. You know, because a lot of us are getting really old now. Well, not really old, but we're getting old now. And, you know, we want to go out. We want to go out with a bang.
Good afternoon, Elements fans everywhere. This is Olympic Stadium. This is the Eastern Final.
November 22nd. The cavernous Olympic Stadium in Montreal is once again the gateway to the Grey Cup. This time, the opponents are the BC Lions, who've reintroduced a familiar weapon.
BC Printers returns and finds the end zone.
Let's go! Play big today! Do your damn thing! Do your thing!
The Speedy Printers has spent almost a year away from football, and the Alouettes know it.
You know, he still maybe have a little rust. From the couch. I don't think they've really seen a D-line like ours and a defense like ours.
I want to shut them out. That's what I want to do. I want to shut them out. I don't know what y'all game plan is.
After warm-ups, the Alouettes locker room is focused and distraction-free.
We have TVs in there, but none of them were turned on. We have stereos in there. Nothing was turned on. Everyone was just, you know, getting ready to go to work.
We start at the beginning of the season saying we're going to walk the walk and talk the talk. Today, we live up to that statement. And let's remind these guys who we are. We're the beast in the CFL. And today
hell yeah!
Let's go!
One, two, three.
We're in!
Alouettes, Lions. Winner moves on to the Grey Cup.
First quarter. And as promised, Montreal's defense attacks, forcing turnovers.
And the Als try to strip the ball up. Shea Emery comes away with the football.
Hey! They ain't seen it like this before. Let's keep going. We do it.
He wants to throw and fires picked off on the outside of the field. Billy Parker, the Alouettes set the trap, and Printers cannot escape.
From there, quarterback Anthony Calvillo begins dissecting the Lions' defense.
One thing that we saw on film that there's times where they might get out of position. They had a couple mental breakdowns, and we just happened to have the right play at the right time to get take advantage of it.
Calvillo throws a dart to Richardson. He sees the goal line. He gets there. Touchdown, Alouettes. End zone celebration again.
Down early, Lions captain G. Roy Simon tries to keep morale high.
Come on, D. There's a whole lot of game left. Let's go, baby.
His message is received.
And it's caught by Paris Jackson for the touchdown.
No!
Holy cow, what a play by KC Printers. Do you believe that?
But as halftime approaches, Calvillo responds to BC's push and takes his team into the lockers with a 20-point lead.
You think Anthony Calvillo has brought his A game?
Second half, BC is looking for a spark, and Ryan Grice Mullen delivers.
Maybe guys started to relax a little bit, and you know, we can't have that.
That's our fault.
Wake up!
That hurt, and you know, since I'm on that punt team, I take my job seriously.
Let's go!
The Lions land their best jab, but they can't handle Calvillo as he immediately responds with a knockout.
He hangs on! Unbelievable grab in the back corner of the end zone. Anthony Calvillo with 5 TD passes in the game.
I really don't know what AC ate for breakfast today, but it was unbelievable.
The biggest thing that we could do was go out there and score and kind of let them know that you know, they can't just get back into this game.
We gotta score a lot. A whole lot.
In the end, the veteran Rich Alouettes are simply too much for BC to handle. The result is inevitable.
It's like a bad dream. All right, let me wake up in about a half an hour and play the game.
Yeah, all right, you're not that bad, man. You're not that bad of a team.
The Alouettes are soaring, and they are on their way to Calgary for a Grey Cup next Sunday.
After the game, Chu and Calvillo immediately find their families. In the twilight of their careers, these moments make the pain and sacrifice worth it.
For my daughter, this is going to be her first ever CFL game, and to win the Eastern Final here, it's words can't describe it.
The thing that got me excited today was just the joy that I saw on my wife's face. It's just great joy to see that everything is paying off for us right now.
When the dust settles, Coach Tressman has a game ball for the team's architect.
That one person is responsible for giving each and every one of us the opportunity to be an Alouette. That's Jim Popper. Yeah. Guys, let's face it, we spent 1 year waiting to say this. We've got some unfinished business. Yeah.
The 97th Grey Cup, when the journey continues.
The Montreal Alouettes back in the Grey Cup. No team has won more games this decade than the Alouettes. But the bottom line in sports is championships. And the record states 1 win, 5 losses in the Grey Cup.
November 29th, Calgary, Alberta, where the journey began for Montreal 5 months prior. McMahon Stadium is the neutral site for the 97th Grey Cup, but neutrality is nowhere to be found.
We underestimated, at least I did, on how many fans Saskatchewan was gonna have here. Really, it was like an away game, like it was a home game for Saskatchewan.
And slowly but surely, McMahon Stadium is starting to look like Mosaic Stadium in Regina.
It's really an impressive sight. Just green everywhere, the odd speck of red.
The West champion Saskatchewan Roughriders have hurdled the border with their entire nation, giving them a decisive advantage. The intense expectations fall squarely on the shoulders of quarterback Darian Durant, who intends on showing why he's the CFL's future.
You know, there's a ton of pent-up energy that is going through the body of Darian Durant, so much so that right now he probably can't even feel his feet.
Inside Montreal's locker room, the mood is palpable.
Know this, man, we gonna respect the game, man, and kick their ass.
And head coach Mark Trestman looks to infuse some last-minute motivation.
I want everybody to do one thing first. Take a deep breath and put a smile on your face.
There we go.
Just take a moment to realize where you are and what you've done. It's 16-3, mm-hmm. With all the praise, individual attention, and team attention that we've had up to this point, we're entitled to what?
Nothing.
Not a thing. Not a thing. And you know what? We're going to go out and embrace that. Let's go out and embrace that. Let's go out and play Alouette football. Violent, unselfish, knowing that every man has got their back and all you got to do is your job. Let's say a prayer and let's go out and win the day.
Well, this is it. The 97th Grey Cup on TSN is underway.
First quarter. Anthony Calvillo and his offense sputter and are unable to move the football.
The Alouettes now 2-0 for the second time in the football game. Calvillo pumps, pressured from Adams.
I think in that first half, I think everybody was expecting somebody else to make plays. That's what the feeling was, especially on offense.
After Calvillo's fumble, Durant wastes no time converting the turnover into points.
Durant into the end zone, touchdown!
That score by Saskatchewan was a huge play in the game, and at that point, I think that's when doubt might have crept in.
Is this the kind of situation where Anthony Calvillo and company say, here we go again?
Second quarter. Montreal takes strides down the field, but out of quick progress comes more regression.
Calvillo, nothing right, dumps it underneath left for Terry Carter. He fumbles the ball out of bounds, and we got a decision down here. What is it?
Laval, and this is a worse shake. That's as bad a kick as you'll ever see.
I don't know what's happened to your punter. This guy is all pro, and he shanked the last two.
The Riders add to their lead off the foot of Luka Kanji. And Montreal, the overwhelming favorite, trudges into the locker room at halftime, trailing 17-3. Once again, the veterans feel their dream slipping away.
And the first half, an unmitigated disaster for the Montreal Alouettes. Man, they got a lot of work to do.
The second half, when the journey continues. The Montreal Alouettes find themselves down 14 at halftime of the Grey Cup, an unfamiliar position for the CFL juggernaut.
There was a lot of chirping going on in the locker room, and then when it all settled down, all of us wanted to, we knew we were better than what we showed in the first half, and we were 16-3 for a great reason, so we figured defense said that they were gonna shut them out, go 2-and-out in that first drive, and then we told the defense that we're gonna go out there and score.
As if on script, the Al's defense attacks, forcing a 2-and-out. From there, it was Calvillo's turn to live up to his word.
This offense from Montreal is starting to get in their rhythm.
Calvillo, straight back, throwing to the end zone. He's got a touchdown, Alouettes! And he goes to his big play man, Jamel Richardson.
Only down 7, Montreal's defense continues its relentless pace, creating turnovers.
Durant throwing deep, and it's picked off. Picked off near the 5 of Montreal, and it's the ball-hogging Billy Parker. And a considerable hush here from Ryderville, Calgary style.
But the turnovers don't translate into points. Montreal can't duplicate their trip to the end zone, and the pressure is rising.
Nobody open, and down goes Calvillo.
You get hit, big boy. You get hit today, 13.
Fourth quarter, Durant can smell blood and takes his Riders downfield for a knockout.
They can't up Durant, running right. He's got room to the 5, to the goal line. Touchdown, Rough Riders.
Teeth of that Alouette defense, and Durant puts it in the end zone.
Montreal is now down 16 with only 10 minutes left. Their faces reflect panic, aggravation, doubt. But Calvillo remains resolute.
In my mind, it was like, okay, we have to, go put up a couple more touchdowns, and looked at the clock and knew in this crazy game in the CFL, you have time.
That perspective would lead to one of the most dramatic comebacks in Grey Cup history.
They know it's slipping away. They've got to get it done right now.
Deep over the middle. What a grab at the 5-yard line. The shakes off a tackle. Touchdown, Alouettes. Avon calling. 6:46 to play. Who wants this night to end? Durant buying time, lobbing it deep. It's up for grabs. It's picked off by Terry Brown of the Alouettes. It's been a long while since we've seen Calvillo go to Cahoon, the future Hall of Fame connection. Are they setting something up here?
Steps up, unload, Bill Cahoon, touchdown!
Calvillo to Melcro hands.
Montreal roars back to within 2 points, but they need the convert to tie. A play Calvillo couldn't execute in a Grey Cup loss to the BC Lions 9 years ago.
Here comes the blitz, Calvillo in the end zone, incomplete! Haskins tripped up!
And like 2000, Calvillo can't execute. Montreal remains down by two. And time is running out.
You see a green here, and they can feel it now. The fans on their feet.
After a defensive stop, Montreal gets the ball back.
So it all comes down to this possession with 40 seconds left on the clock.
Calvillo completes two passes, inching his team to kicker Damon Duval's range, setting up a field goal for the win.
Now the 13th man will try and take over.
High snap, but the hold is there. Duval has the distance.
To see the kick come off his foot and heading wide, pit in my belly hurt.
And the kick is wide. All kinds of flags. Jason Armstead running it out.
When I saw the snap, I saw a flag from behind the goal, and I know from behind the goal, the only flag you can possibly throw is a too many men flag.
Illegal substitution, too many men on the field, Saskatchewan.
Oh my.
Oh, you gotta wonder who that guy is. I'd hate to be that 13th guy if Duval hits his kick.
Right away, everyone knew it was too many men, and we knew we had another chance.
Here we go again, 0-0 showing on the clock, the kick is up.
Instant. Years of heartache and disappointment are swept aside.
What a joyful event. What a joyful event!
The Alouettes are once again Grey Cup champions.
This journey is finally over. We've suffered a lot of heartache and adversity the last few years. Feels very nice to actually be on the winning end of one and all. It's been a while.
When you look at the way things ended, I truly believe that there was a big part of faith involved. The stars were aligned for us to win.
This game goes down in history now and will be talked about forever.
We got a heck of a group of men in this room. We got believers.
Yeah.
We got guys that love each other.
Yeah.
And we haven't exceeded our expectations. We've gotten exactly what we've expected.
We deserve it! We deserve it!
We're the CFL champions, man.
Yeah!